I think as a songwriter, there is that urge to connect. There is that urge to say, like, this is how I feel sometimes, and then have fans say, oh my God, like, I feel that way sometimes too. And I think a documentary, if you are open enough, you can connect with people. I tell you that you'll never find another like
me. Being in the studio was, that was some of my favorite stuff that we filmed.
That was the first time I've ever had a camera crew in the studio. Mm. It's always been really off limits. Mm. It was actually amazing having you in the studio because like we'd finish writing a song and like a sound guy would be like, that's a really good song.
I'd be like, right.
Thank you. Actually, we never get this in the studio. Nobody ever is like, hey, no, that's a good one.
Right. keep going.
I just honestly had no idea how it would affect the creative process. Mm-hmm. We ended up with you in the studio writing songs like Me and The Man.
Hey, then I'd be the man, I'd be the man.
That is a concept I've thought about for so many years, but I just always thought like, I want to say it in a way that's like a satire and that's kind of funny, mm-hmm. but it's also making a very serious point. I think when I hit on this idea of like, if I was a man, I'd be the man. Like, you guys would think I was so cool if I was doing this stuff and I was a guy. Like, you know, and I could get away with this, I could get away with this, I could get away with this, I get applauded for this.
We drink to the pit and the bottles, to the bitches and models, to the da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-
strong, wonderful, intelligent young daughters. Mm. And I think he, you know, I think he was writing for them.
Yeah.
And I love showing that we really do have allies in the male civilization.
What I love about that scene in the film is that, you know, sometimes the camera is right here as you come up with the lyric. How much did you notice us?
I know what you mean, because you really were very close to my face in a lot of it. I don't think we ever like asked you guys, like, can you go? Like,
right.
Because you just weren't invasive at all. I think I was really in my feelings. I just get really
in
it when I'm writing a song and I disappear into my phone because my phone is where I keep my notes and my phone is where I'm editing.
The field of north, found someone to commit to.
Every time I wake up in the middle of the night, or every time I think of a title, or every time I think of a common phrase and flip it, I love doing that. I'll put it in my notes, but
yeah, there's a real speed to it too. Like, it seems like writing a song has a kind of dynamic where you go and you kind of have to keep going for many hours a lot of the time until it's done.
Yeah, I have to do that. Everyone's different with their writing. A lot of people are stop, start. I know people who will write a verse for one song and decide to just put it on another song. Or like, I like this chorus, but I like it with this pre-chorus from this song. And I'm like, never done that once. I kind of have to capitalize on the excitement of me getting that idea and see it all the way through, or else I'll leave it behind and I'll just assume it wasn't good enough.
Shit.
Oh my God, did we just do like this whole verse and chorus?
The ideas are my favorite part of of everything that I do. That moment where you're like, oh, I know what it's called. Or you're like, I know what the hook is now.
And there's one point in the movie where you actually see on your face, you go like, because you have an idea. You get to see it.
Took the money in the bag and I stole
the keys.
That was the last time you ever saw me.
I remember when I used to get an idea when I was 12 years old in my room. I'd first get an idea and I'd be like, yes, idea. And then I'd get this like fear and almost sorrow that no one was ever gonna hear it. I'm never gonna get to make this into something. It's just mine. And like, there's something cute about that, but like, I wanna make something. Getting to capture on films, you know, getting an idea, that's one thing that I'm glad I'll have forever. I'll always have kind of a memory of when that idea happened, that idea happened. I'd never had that before. Anyway, it's good that we both get to make things now.
We're so lucky.